I've come to understand that love is fundamentally conditional. Despite the widespread belief in its unconditional nature, this idea of unconditional love fascinates us, prompting a quest for someone who will love us completely, without any reservations. Yet, this concept is as fictional as Santa Claus or the Easter Bunny. Expecting to find unconditional love is as unrealistic as searching for mythical beings, often leading to disappointment when we realize that every relationship is bound by its conditions and expectations. All love is conditional, but it isn't transactional. This is a crude distinction, for transactional love feels like a bargain. I love you if you give me something in return. In contrast, conditional love depends on certain qualities and attributes, without a direct exchange. These conditions might include shared values, mutual respect, or deep emotional connections. And these elements are the bedrock of a meaningful and lasting relationship. When these conditions are absent, love can wither, underscoring the importance of acknowledging and nurturing these underlying factors. Observing love in various forms reveals its conditional nature in itself. Close friendships thrive because of shared interests, values, and experiences. I think we all know how that feels with you and I and our love for Team Fortress 2. This is conditional love. Romantic love operates on similar principles. Though we often deny it, pursuing unconditional love sets us up for frustration as we chase an unattainable ideal. This pursuit blinds us to the beauty in conditional love. Romantic love operates on similar principles, though we often deny it. Pursuing unconditional love sets us up for frustration as we chase an unattainable ideal. This pursuit blinds us to the beauty of conditional love, which, while imperfect, is genuine and deeply rooted in mutual understanding and compatibility. Appreciating the conditions that bind us to others can foster stronger and more resilient relationships. Many of us have experienced what we thought was unconditional love through a childhood crush or something similar. Falling for someone instantly and believing that if they knew our true selves, if they knew us, they would reciprocate our feelings. It's a common experience. However, this belief is an illusion. The object of our fantasy is not the real person, but a perversion, an idealized version we create in our own heads, our minds. This idealization creates a perfect image that can never really match. The intensity of a crush often fades when confronted with the complexities of a real relationship, revealing the conditional nature of our affections. Reminds me of when I was a kid. I remember a crush from my youth, a girl who seemed perfect. One day, during a lunch break, we had a casual conversation. For the record, this girl I thought I would marry and have many kids with and I'd spend the rest of my life with. My illusion of her began to shatter during this conversation. It was nothing irregular, more of a maturity of character on my end, I suppose, and certainly not the ideal waifu I would have hoped for or imagined, but my crush just seemed like someone I would be incompatible with. Even besides mutual lustful desires, this moment was a stark lesson in the fragility of idealizations and the importance of seeing people as they truly are, not as we wish them to be. It underscored the need to ground our affections in reality, accepting the flaws and imperfection that truly makes us human. There's this idea that Western culture uniquely emphasizes the concept of a perfect romantic love, a notion stemming from Dante's Divine Comedy. Dante's muse, Beatrice, who he barely knew, inspired this work. His love for her was based on fleeting encounters, not a deep, unconditional bond. This romantic ideal has permeated our culture, creating unrealistic expectations for relationships. Seeking a Beatrice, a perfect lover from dreams and literature, distracts us from appreciating the imperfect yet profound connections we form in real life. True love is built on shared experiences, mutual respect, and understanding. Consider the bond between a father and a son, or the father and the son. A man may believe he loves his child unconditionally. However, discovering that the child is not biologically his can change this love entirely. Despite the boy's innocence, the condition of biological connection, once broken, alters their relationship entirely. This scenario highlights the complex nature of love and the conditions underpinning it. For the father's emotional turmoil reveals how deeply ingrained these conditions can be, affecting his sense of identity and the bond he shares with his child, genetic or not. Understanding and acknowledging these conditions is crucial for navigating the complexities of modern-day relationships and our own. Yet, true love, as depicted in media, often seems ideal, but it's not found in such a way you are ever planning to pursue it. It's portrayed as perfect, but in reality, everyone enters a relationship seeking benefits of some kind. This approach is flawed and fallible. Two people barely know each other, interacting mainly to satiate desires or avoid their own loneliness. These don't last long, and they often don't last long together, and they fall out of love very quickly. Similar is modern marriage, understandably. Love is conditional. A woman might love her husband deeply, but if he loses his ability to provide due to misfortune or poor decisions, her feelings might change. This shift is not due to materialism, but because of one of the implicit conditions of the relationship: security and stability. It's been compromised. This change forces her to reassess her expectations and the viability of their partnership. The condition of provision encompasses broader aspects of reliability, trust, the ability to build a secure future together. When these conditions are sneered, severed, it challenges the foundation of their love, prompting a reevaluation of the relationship entirely. Conditions in love can be explicit or implicit, specific or general. General conditions might include being kind, healthy, and non-abusive. Specific conditions varying from person to person. Understanding and acknowledging these conditions is crucial for building realistic and healthy relationships. I find that openly discussing and negotiating these conditions can build a foundation of mutual respect, understanding, and this transparency fosters trust and helps prevent misunderstanding and unmet expectations, which can erode the relationship over time. Recognizing that all love is conditional does not diminish its value. Rather, it empowers us to cultivate deeper, more meaningful connections based on mutual respect and shared values. Though it is as such, true love isn't a fiery passion-driven emotion that leaves you ecstatic or drained. Many people stay together for the kids, money, or work, and sometimes not even then. True love is a deep friendship that evolves and blossoms. You've seen each other at your best and worst, spent significant time before your understanding of sex and intimacy, and shared laughs, cries, and fights. Now you're close, because you genuinely enjoy each other's company. It's not rocket science. Over time, you develop similar tastes. When it evolves into romance, your relationship remains as strong as before, with the bonus of intimacy. This is the greatest kind of love between partners. At this point, what could break you up? Nothing would divorce your souls at that point. The key takeaway is this: searching for unconditional love is futile because it does not exist. Recognize the conditions you bring to a relationship and those you expect in return. Once understood, these dynamics lead to more fulfilling and realistic connections. Everyone has expectations and judgments. it's vital to be honest about them with yourself and others. Embracing the conditional nature of love allows for the appreciation of the true depth and complexity of a relationship, thus fostering a more authentic and enriching experience of love. And by acknowledging and respecting these conditions, such relationships can be navigated with greater clarity, compassion, and resilience. Thank you, and good luck.